When we were making our second record, we got to work with the incredible producer T-Bone Burnett, who you probably have heard his music and the work that he's created. He's an amazing person, and he has so many relationships that are larger than life. And we were in the studio with him in Los Angeles a few years ago, and we thought that we were done making our record while we were writing songs for it, and we thought that we had written all of the songs for that record. And he came in one day and he said, "Sit down, girls." And so we sat down and he said, "I want you to listen to these 5 songs that Bob sent over. And they're not finished yet, but he wants you to listen to them and choose your favorite one and finish writing it and then record it to go on your new record." And the Bob that T-Bone was so casually referring to was none other than the incredible songwriter Bob Dylan, which is, you know, no pressure at all.
Just an up-and-comer.
Yeah, you know, he's kind of new.
He wanted us to help him.
Yeah, and he was like, and so we thought, okay, well, we'll help him. Which, of course, I'm being completely facetious because
really?
We were terrified. I mean, to say terrified, that's an understatement because, you know, here we are, 2 little redneck girls from Alabama who barely managed to graduate high school, and we are having to finish a song for arguably the greatest American songwriter in the history of American songwriting. And so we felt completely ill-equipped for such a task, but we felt that it would be very foolish to say, "No, thank you, Bob Dylan, maybe later." And so we said, "We will try." And so we went to our hotel room and we finished writing our favorite song out of the bunch, and we recorded it to go on our record. And, you know, at the time it felt like a really, you know, David and Goliath kind of moment where we have this larger-than-life songwriter and then these 2 very inexperienced songwriters. But it's pretty funny to me because not too long after we finished writing this song for Bob Dylan, he just so happened to win a Nobel Prize. And I just don't think that's a coincidence. I don't believe it. And I mean, he hadn't won a Nobel Prize until we finished that song.
It's the only thing that exists.
It's the correlation between the 2 events. It really is. It's amazing. And it's, you know, it's been a couple years since he won the Nobel Prize, and we are waiting on our, I think they send a trophy or a medal, and we haven't received ours yet, but we heard it takes a long time to engrave your name on the trophy, so we're waiting, and we know that in his heart, Bob Dylan is aware that we played a very vital role in his winning of the Nobel Prize, so any day now, Bob,
you're welcome.
That felt very sacrilegious to me. Nevertheless, we're going to play the song that we finished for poor old Bob Dylan because he couldn't do it without us.
Keep going.